village is, you know, Ixtlilxan is up in the mountains. I mean, there's so much wind that can be harnessed for something like electricity, and also starting a social entrepreneurship aspect. That village definitely could use it.
Mi nombre es María Martina Tepas López. Aquí en el pueblo de Santa Catarina es un pueblo muy humilde.
There's a strong community here. It's a Mayan community. One of the biggest problems here is poverty. A lot of people don't have good jobs to support their families.
But this has to be level two.
Oh. We are a group of Michigan engineering students.
Not that way. Yeah.
I mean, trying to make a difference in the world.
Todas nosotras las mujeres trabajamos sobre el tejido.
Sí. The women weave. And they weave very well, but it's hard to sell it. And when they do manage to sell it, it's often at a very low price. Compounding this is the fact that there's an alcoholism problem in the community, and a lot of times women are responsible for making sure the basic necessities like firewood and sugar are paid for.
We are developing a wind turbine system with the blades made of woven material. And we're specifically targeting women in Guatemala who support themselves through weaving. We're working with them to co-design blades with the woven material.
You gotta drill the holes, screw it on.
Okay, yeah.
We made a couple mistakes in manufacturing things, but we were able to find replacement parts that were very serviceable for what we needed.
Go in on.
Para mí eso lo que están haciendo si es genera luz.
She says it's important because, because it provides electricity, and the electricity here is very expensive. Some people, families end up paying more than $200 a month, or 200 quetzales a month. Also, it's a good opportunity for women to earn a steady income.
The goal is to get everything made in Guatemala.
Oh my God.
So that, you know, it can be sold, make profit, and then, you know, generate clean electricity.
The plans that we have for implementing the turbine system is that there would be different components of the turbine that different people in the village would be working on different parts, and so they'd be like selling things in between them, and then putting up wind turbines. It would create an environment where the women could sell their weavings to make profit off that, and then the weavings would go on the blades. Someone else could be making the frame for the blade and stuff like that.
I think another goal of the project is just to make it affordable. We noticed when we were down there, we brought Kevlar to use as a material for our blades, and it was just way too expensive. It was about $100 for one of our blades.
I think this whole trip for me was just a big learning experience.
That. Yeah, we all learned that. The third day, we started in the morning. We had none of the stand built. So we worked so hard that day, and by the end of the day, we had something standing, and the transmission figured out.
We have to take it off about 2 centimeters.
That was probably another highlight of the trip, I think. Yeah. Everyone was like, all the women and their families and all the kids, and the
LED setup.
The dad of the family came back from work. And we were able to turn the blades. We had 2 blades, a blue and a maize one, of course. And we were able to turn the blades, and an LED lit up.
Yes! Yes! You see a light? Oh!
And that was really cool for everyone to see.
We're really happy. We got a lot farther than we thought we would.
Awesome.
¿Piensa usted que sirve en el futuro?
Yo digo que sí.
Yeah.
Espero que sí. Sí.
Yeah. Bueno, muchas gracias.
I'm going to go to the hospital. I'm going to go to the hospital. I'm going to go to the hospital.